Hey guys, Nick here. Welcome back to another video. In today's video, we have a ton of news to get to, such as news from the past 2 days and into today, such as Bobby Ryan being now a UFA. He got bought out. If you can't tell, I'm a little bit stuffed up right now. I don't know why. We have, Mug Stahl, now a Detroit Red Wing. Who saw that coming? We're going to talk about that trade. We have the Dallas Stars keeping the playoff hopes alive. Of course, winning last night in double overtime to send this to a game number 6. We have a lot to get to today. I'm going to see if I will be able to with this running notes, and let's get into it. So, of course, let's start with the big news that came out now 2 days ago. Of course, Bobby Ryan no longer with the Ottawa Senators. He got bought out. I believe he had three or four years remaining on his contract. It will save the Ottawa Senators $22 million in cap space. I half understand it, half not. I mean, Bobby Ryan was a big leader in this locker room, and obviously he missed a lot of the season due to his alcohol problems and stuff, and he got sober, he came back, he scored a hat trick. It was incredible to watch. And obviously, it's really sad, but I don't think he'll have a problem at all finding another team. He's a fighter. Much respect to the guy. And I really do hope, and I really do believe, he will find a team to go on to next year. I know he still has game in him. I definitely do you believe he will not have trouble finding another team next year. He will play in the NHL next year, hands down. He should. He deserves it for all that he's been through lately. And, it's awesome for a guy like him to come back after that. And, I really, really hope. I keep saying it. I really do believe he'll get a team next year. Yet again, I think he was a pretty good guy to have on the team. I think there were other people Ottawa could have bought out. Bobby Ryan does make the most sense to buy out. So, I am sad about this, but I'm not surprised, if that makes sense. That's how I'm feeling right now. And, yeah, Bobby Ryan, officially a free agent. Okay, next thing on our agenda is the trade that happened last night. Mug Stahl and a 2021 second round pick going from the Rangers to the Detroit Red Wings in exchange for future considerations. Now, I see this trade as a win for both sides here. More Detroit than the Rangers getting the W here, but I understand this trade from both sides here. Of course, Mark Stahl has been probably one of the worst defensemen in the league lately. But first off, we're going to talk about why this is a win for the New York Rangers. Like I mentioned, Mark Stahl, one of the worst defensemen in the NHL the past couple of years. He hasn't been good. But they finally get him off their hands. He makes they definitely clear a lot of cap space with trading him. Obviously they had to give up that second just so someone could take, as a bit of a sweetener for someone to take Mark Stahl, which is, I'm expecting that, but the Rangers do clear cap space though in this trade. Obviously they can now re-sign center Ryan Strome and defenseman Tony DeAngelo, both put up, I think, 50 something points this year, something like that. They both played really good this season, and, both are a good fit in the Rangers, and I think signing them both will be huge for the Rangers. It'll be good for them, and I definitely like this trade for the Rangers. They're getting cap space, so they can re-sign two good players of the organization. Now, going to the Red Wings here, the reason they get a win here, and the reason why I more see them as a win is because, as we know, they're a younger team. They're more in the rebuilding phase, getting more good prospects and stuff. Mark Stahl, great, great leadership. He's definitely going to be helping those young guns, quite a bit here. He'll be helping those younger players learn, especially those younger defensemen that they have, like, my mind's going blank, but, yeah, they'll be helping those younger, especially those younger defensemen, on the Detroit Red Wings, you know, learn some stuff and just really be able to elevate their game based off of Mark Stahl, his leadership and stuff and tips and stuff, because, as we know, Mark Stahl's played in the league for 15 years, I think, now, so 10 or 15 years. But, yeah, so, I believe it's 15. Anyway, but also I see this as a win for the Detroit Red Wings because they get that second round pick, which is awesome and can really help this team, especially when you're a rebuilding team and you want to get as many picks as possible in a good draft. That certainly helps the Red Wings in this case as well. So I see this trade as both a win for the Detroit Red Wings and also for the New York Rangers. It helps both sides. It makes sense. And yeah, on to a last bit of, I guess not news, but more like a recap of last night. So last night, the Tampa Bay Lightning, they needed to, if they would have won, they would have won the Stanley Cup. They would have. However, Mr. Anaheim himself, according to NBCSN, won the Cup with San Jose in 2007, which, you know, he won with Anaheim. Anyway, basically, Scorey Perry, Mr. Scorey Perry, scored 2 goals, including the double overtime winner to keep the keep the Dallas Stars in the running for the Stanley Cup. Of course, Joe Pavelski scored his 61st career playoff goal, which puts him first on the leaderboard among American players for the most goals in the Stanley Cup playoff career. Was Jumbo Joe Pavelski never won a Stanley Cup. He came, you know, he finished, I wouldn't say he finished, but he lost in the Stanley Cup final 2016 to my Pittsburgh Penguins. It's great for him. He has 4 goals this series. He's really playing good when he needs to. And, I mean, you know, the San Jose Sharks and the Anaheim Duck, both playing good, you know. Both 2 free agent signings, signing with Dallas last offseason, you know, both in the first year in Dallas organization. And they're definitely making a statement here, keeping their season alive. Obviously, I was pretty scared there. But, you know, it's great. I personally want the Stars to win, but I wouldn't be mad if Tampa Bay won because I like both of those teams. I love Tyler Seguin. Like I mentioned before on this channel, he's one of my favorite players in the league. He hasn't done nothing this postseason, unfortunately. But yet again, Steven Stamkos holding the cup, even though he didn't do anything, would also be a pretty funny moment to witness. And also, adding on with Phil the Thrill, Hot Dog Boy Lovin', amazing superstar, Phil Kessel, the big rig, Patty Maroon, 2-time Stanley Cup champion. Him and Phil Kessel, the 2-time back-to-back Stanley Cup champions. You'd love to hear it. Now, Game 6, of course, is on Monday at 8 o'clock. And I'm going to leave this video off with a question for you guys. Do you guys think the Tampa Bay Lightning will win the Stanley Cup tomorrow? Or will the Dallas Stars keep it alive and get this series to 7 games? Let me know your thoughts in the comments below, as well as everything else. Just a little bit of, you know, just trying to think of a little bit of more, added some rumors and stuff. Joseph Blandisi re-signed with Montreal, so did Jeff Petrie. Rumors coming out that Alexander Wenberg might be bought out, which would be good for Columbus. Craig Smith, excuse me, is testing the free agent market. Yeah, a bit of rumors and stuff here going on. But yeah. So, there's like your little update, I guess, around the league. If you guys enjoy this, make sure to leave a like for more videos. Make sure to subscribe if you're new to the channel. Make sure to click that notification button. so you always never miss a video. Anyway, I'm Nick, and I will see you guys later. Bye!